solar energy being variable. For example, whenever there's a cloud coverage over a photovoltaic cell, there's going to be variation of the intensity of the solar energy that is received by a solar panel. Similarly, during the daytime, there's decrease in intensity, and there's increase and decrease in intensity. And also during nighttime, we don't have solar power. So that means that energy storage is an integral part of harnessing solar photovoltaic energy. And that is something that is very important for us as we go towards tens of gigawatts of rooftop solar PV systems. Our aim in this energy domain sector is towards making this possible through efficient and environmental friendly devices of which can go together with solar photovoltaic systems and provide a useful service in terms of maintaining continuous supply of electricity. So this is one of the important verticals of the ISEC center, and we are currently looking at different flow battery, redox flow battery systems, which go together, which share characteristics that are common with solar photovoltaic system. That is long life, because PV systems can last for some 15-20 years, and we are also looking at large number of cycles. Over this period, there will be thousands of cycles of charge and discharge. We are also looking at large storage capacity and large power capacity, because again, when we look at a solar PV system, it can be anything between several kilowatts to several megawatts or several tens and hundreds of megawatt systems. So we need to have a capability to harness and store and distribute large amounts of power and large amounts of energy storage. Among the many systems that are feasible, redox flow batteries, where you have an electrolyte being circulated through the battery, has come out to be one of the top contenders, especially for stationary installations of solar photovoltaic systems. What we are doing in the Energy Domain Center at ISEC is to look at second generation vanadium redox flow batteries. Vanadium redox flow batteries are all liquid electrolytes in which the electricity conversion and electricity electrical energy storage is done through active species, which are always in liquid phase. So that means that there is no gas evolution, there is no solid deposition, and this improves their life and this improves the operability of these kind of systems. So we are looking at second generation systems which are more efficient, which have higher power density and higher energy density than what are currently there in the market. Another important focus for the energy storage domain is to develop batteries which can work in harsh environments, especially at high altitudes, at very low ambient temperatures. We know that ambient temperature has an important effect on the life of a battery, and when the ambient temperature is very low, you can have sharp degradation of performance of a battery. We'd like to develop batteries which can withstand a temperature of minus 20 degrees, minus 30 degrees or minus 10 degrees and still have efficiency and life which can be maintained over a long duration. So that is another aspect of our solar energy system. One more important aspect of energy domain is to look at energy solutions that are environmentally friendly and sustainable, which means that if we use electrolytes, chemicals which cannot be disposed of easily, then it's not sustainable, it's not environmentally friendly. So we are looking at different chemistries, redox chemistries, which can give us efficient electrochemical energy storage that is also environmentally friendly and sustainable on a large scale. Thank you.